So, I will talk here about Osmos QR. So it's a tool part of the list he talked about. Osmos QR is less known here in United States and America because he start in Europe and just this year come here. So it's a quality tool like the list previously. See, it's an data analysis with a list of rules, but it's also check a part of completeness with open data by checking missing open data. It's not in concurrence with other quality tools because we not duplicate the rules. When there is a rules in KeepRight or other tool, we don't re-implement again in Osmos. And when you the tool suggests correction, it not focus on a way when there is multiple way, like addressing with relation or result. So it's a web interface of Osmos. You can see a large map with marker and marker of color. Color depend on categories of error. There is a list of items. Items are categorized by structure or missing tags or thing to correct by category like geometry, tagging. On the upper part, you can see severity because issue reported are classified by severity. The first is the one severity with more important possible error on the map. And then there is two and three. Just after you see a fixable. Fixable is when issue is reported with a correction suggested. Correction suggestion. Are not always possible, like when there is a building intersection, we can not automatically see what it's a correction, and you have to check yourself. But sometimes is missing capitals in name, so we can suggest to add the capital. On the menu part, on the right, there is a possibility to log in on openstreetmap.org, and when you do this, there is a list of your error or your report error based on the last user edit a feature. It's not an issue you make yourself, but where you're the last editor of the object. I miss a part. Just after fixable, there is topic. Topic is a kind of object of interest, like igway or name or bicycle. There is a list of topic. In this list of topics, there is, for example, fixing with imagery. So you can just see error when you need imagery to fix, or you need to survey, or you just need armchair and look at tags and fix it. This is done for correction on the ground. You can survey with a mobile device and activate only error that need to be surveyed on the field. With this interface, you can export error to other tools like JSON, or export a GPX file to set on a mobile device. When you look up at a marker, there is a pop-up in the pop-up, there is many things. The more important is the kind of error and the description. What about there is this error? And which object is suspected? In orange, you can see a proposition of correction. This is a correction on French because there is different rules on different countries. It's not a global rules for all countries around the world, but there is specific thing by country. In this one, you can see there is missing a capital letter. So if you click on the fix JSON or fix edit, you can load this object with fixed capital in JSON or in other editors. Once you correct it, you can click on corrected or false positive. Corrected is when you done the job and it's fine. And false positive is when Osmos report an error, but it's not an error. You can signal it so we can fix the detector and improve the list of error. In the upper part, there is a link to the wiki, the OpenStreetMap wiki, where there is a page with a list of error and explanation about the error and how to do to fix the error with the explanation. When you use the fix edit or the edit link, not the JSON link. JSON link load and remote in JSON. But when you fix edit or edit, you have a small editor inside Osmos. It's for use on the ground. When you use a mobile device on the ground, you don't have a JSON or you don't want to use other editor. So you have a small tag editor, tag only editor. So you can change the name, add a tag, remove. And as you can see, there is color. It's a differential editor. It's a nice feature. I think I would like to have a thing like this in JSON. And when you're done on the ground, on the field, you can save and it's make a change set. So this is the actual coverage country. Because it needs a lot of computation power, there is no full coverage. Since this spring, with the help of Mapbox, we found a server to coverage North America, and there is available now. There is still missing a lot of Asia and Oceania part. In the top, you can see heat map of error. It's density of error. So when you don't zoom on the map, you can see where there is a lot of error and look what about. As you see, there is a big red dot. It's probably about import. Import where there is a small error in the import, but there is on many, many objects. But then do many, many errors. We start coverage with France 5 years ago, and then add a server time by time. A lot of servers are from OpenStreetMap France, and now there are others around the whole world, like in Brazil or Iceland. So we see the front-end part. We see the user part with the map and the marker for correction. But in the back-end part, there is a lot of server and a lot of manipulation data. We start with OpenStreetMap data and open data set. And we use many servers. The server sends the issue report to the front-end and then display to the user. Why we split the data? Because it's many, many data. And by splitting it, we can apply different rules by country. like language or abbreviation and unabbreviate word of word or in street name depending on country and language. Actually, we have a big progression with the help of the Mapbox sponsor, but we need still more server and more power computation to do the full world. The split have another advantage too. It's to implicate local community in local way of mapping. There is not the same way to do mapping around the world. It's a particularity true for address. There is some kind of different backend analyzer. The first one and the simplest one is based on one object. We check the tag object and we report an error only on one object at a time. So there is an example, a simple example, an oversimplified example, where we define a kind of error, too many space, there is a successive space. We set the error is about name and can be fixed with the chair. So you have nothing more, you need nothing more to correct the error. So we have just a simple test written here in Python, and then we have a possible issue fix by simply removing a successive space. This is a simple analyzer. A more complicated analyzer is based on geometry. For geometry, we use database. And the check are more complicated because we can check tag and geometry on multiple objects at once to detect error. This example is about reverse roundabout. We can check the right one way of a roundabout depending on the country and report error. The last kind of analyzer is about open data. With open data set, we can check missing object and completeness in OpenStreetMap. We need to map open data set with OpenStreetMap tag. First, we describe the source file. We no modify the source file and use as is because it's easier for update when open data need update. Then we choose which tag in OpenStreetMap we want, and then we do a conflation or a merge. As a result, we have three kind of report. The missing object in OpenStreetMap, the object in OpenStreetMap not in open dataset, sometimes it happens, and the last, the suggestion, object in OpenStreetMap that can be conflated with an open data set object, and we can report a new tag on the OpenStreetMap. With the last addition of USA and Germany, we have new many errors, mainly due to large import of data in USA. This is a total of error, but it's not the more interesting one. The level one, the more important error, are many less time. Here it's a France graph. It starts not at the start of the project, but because we not have a history. But the important part is the last part. It's the flat. It's flat because it's corrected in real time. There is new error, there is new analysis in Osmose, but there is contributors that check error. If we look at USA, where we start this year, the errors are corrected, but slowly, because the tool is not well known yet. And I hope you start using it for checking more errors. In Germany, there is more flat because there is a more recent open of Osmose. Some stats about Osmose. I'll not tell you the number because it's hard to miss the number in English. But we have many servers around the world and many rules to check the data. If you want an update of the rules on some area of a new check, it's possible to ask and we do it. And also, if you want, we add an open data set for merge, it's possible too. Since last year, we had a Maproulette bridge, so we sent some of the result of Osmose QA to the Maproulette. There is an item where start with world, but it takes time to correct it even with Maproulette because there is many errors around the world. So some links. Some question? Okay. Yes?
Question about the size of the team maintaining the servers and the whole project. How many people are working on this?
We are two actually, two French. The question is about the size of the team. We are two French. Me on development and code, and Jocelyn on maintaining the server and and there is other people, but there is not involved too much. That check result. They maintain external server, but they are not implicated more. Okay, thank you.